So I'm gonna assume you decided to start email marketing, but now you want some help getting everything set up properly. If so, you're exactly in the right place, because I'm going to give you an in-depth, step-by-step email marketing tutorial that'll take you from opening an account to creating sign-up forms for growing your email list, building your emails, and setting up automated workflows so your messages are easily sent on autopilot. Make sure you watch to the end of the video, because we'll also look at how you can make sure your emails land in the inbox instead of the spam folder, and how you can keep your subscriber list free from fake and inactive email addresses. My name is Bernard, the Director of Content here at Omnisend, and in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to get started with email marketing. So, why should you incorporate email as part of your marketing efforts? It's simple. Email has the highest ROI of any marketing channel, and you can reach your subscribers whenever you want. You're not relying on some algorithm to show your brand in someone else's feed or bidding against competitors on PPC ads. With email, you can reach your customers whenever you want. But that's not all. Here are some other reasons. People choose to hear from you because they like your products or service and want to hear more. You can split your audience into groups and send very specific messages to them. It's cheap or entirely free, and like paid ads, you don't need to put money into email marketing unless your needs are too big for the free plan on your chosen platform. Easy, intuitive software like Omnisend does a lot of the heavy lifting for you, meaning your emails will be working even when you're not. In order to deep dive into email marketing, I'm going to be using Omnisend in this video. Omnisend is an intuitive platform with features specifically designed for e-commerce, including ready-to-use templates and workflows so you can get up and running immediately. And we've even got a special deal for our viewers. For a limited time, you can get 10% off of 3 months by using the code FOUND on YouTube. That's FOUND on YouTube, one word. Just follow the link in the description below. Okay, now it's time to make your account. We're going to simply sign up at Omnisend's registration page, and I'll show you what you'll see when you log in. On your dashboard, you'll see the option to connect your store. If your store is on a compatible platform like Shopify, BigCommerce, or WooCommerce, you can link it directly to Omnisend and enjoy a number of benefits. These benefits include the ability to directly add products from your store into your emails. This saves you loads of time and couldn't be any simpler to use. From within the email builder, just select a product and the email will automatically add its title, description, image, and price. Other platforms make you add all of this manually, and you can imagine how long that would take. The second option on your dashboard saves you even more time. Once you connect your store, Omnisend can automatically identify your branding, your logo, font, colors, even your social media links. Of course, you can set this manually as well if you want to make changes or you haven't connected your store yet. But here's the best part about this. When your branding is added, Omnisend will automatically add it to every single email that you create in the future. And not only that, but when you look at the template gallery, your branding appears there too. So you'll see exactly what the email will look like. Our customers say this feature has cut in half the amount of time it takes to create email campaigns. You shouldn't have any difficulty setting up the rest of your account, so we won't spend too much focusing on that here. But you can always head to the store settings area to check out your choices. Now, before you send emails, you'll want to get forms in place so people can sign up to hear from you. Omnisend has multiple tools to help you grow an audience. Popups and embedded forms, the Wheel of Fortune, and landing pages. Let's look at each in closer detail. If you've ever been on the internet, and you probably are right now, you've seen pop-ups. You visit a website and a box pops up asking you to enter your email address. Although they have a reputation as being kind of annoying, they also have a very impressive 4% conversion rate. They're also very customizable. They can take up the entire screen or a tiny box that sits in the corner of the screen. Pop-ups can appear immediately when you land on a site or after a specific period of time, say 10 seconds, or when a certain percentage of the page has been scrolled. The idea with these options is that the visitor has shown some level of engagement with the site, so they're more likely to sign up than a person who just saw the pop-up form instantly. An embedded form is similar to a pop-up, except it's permanently on the page and in a fixed place. It doesn't appear suddenly and it doesn't change places. If you set it halfway down the page, the visitor will have to scroll to that point in order to see it. So, something to remember. An embedded form can include multiple fields, including name, email address, phone number, and some custom elements. The Wheel of Fortune is an interactive, gamified form that's actually fun to use. Like a pop-up, you choose when it appears, but your visitors can click on it to set the wheel spinning. They then watch the wheel spin and come to a stop with the pointer telling them what they've won. The segments on the wheel are customizable, so you can decide what the prizes are and the odds of winning. A landing page is a dedicated page with its own link you can send people to. While the forms you've already looked at will show up on your existing pages, a landing page is completely separate from the rest of your site. One of the benefits is that this page can be clear, concise, and focused on one specific thing. In comparison, visitors can land on your website and visit a number of other pages, which makes it a bit harder to have one message or CTA. With a landing page, though, you can have a clear CTA and field for the visitor to sign up. You can also share the URL in your emails on social media profiles and ads, sending focused traffic to a dedicated landing page. And with a massive 24.8% conversion rate, landing pages are highly effective. Creating a pop-up, embedded form, wheel of fortune, or a landing page all happens in the same area of your Omnisend account. So let's explore those steps for now. When you're logged in, choose Forms along the top of the screen, and then the Create Form button to the right side. Here, you'll see lots of templates and filtering options. You could filter by goals, such as to collect subscribers or promote offers, or by the form's theme, such as celebrating a holiday. You can filter by pop-up, embedded form, or landing page in the type section, and Wheel of Fortune is in the form settings section. The process is similar for building forms and landing pages, so for this demonstration, we'll select pop-up in the type list, and then choose the first form on the page. It then takes us to the form builder page. This is where you can customize the form to your like. Using the items panel on the left, you can add new fields to collect emails and phone numbers, add a legal consent checkbox, and a dropdown to collect additional information such as country, gender, or custom information of your choice. You can also change the layout here from one column to four. Once the form is finished, you can set a success message or when people have submitted their information. Underneath the form, you'll see two boxes, Form and Success. Click Success and you'll be able to edit this part of the form. The Wheel of Fortune has some different options, so let's look at those quickly. From the form template page, tick the box next to Wheel of Fortune and we'll choose the first template. If you click on the wheel, the right-hand panel will show color options, so you can change the appearance of each slice. There's also a button here that says Setup Wheel Slices. Click that and you'll be able to set the text, discounts, and probabilities for each slice. Hit Save and you can edit more of the appearance. Click on the headline to change it, and click on the field and the Spin It button to change the text and appearance of these two. As with the previous form we built, you can change the success message too. Under the Wheel of Fortune area, click Success and make the changes you want. Once the form you're working on is to your liking, it's time to look on the right side to tweak the settings. In the Behavior tab, you can add tags to anyone who signs up to your list using this form. It's optional, but a great way to break your audience into segments. You can also set a schedule. The form can be active all the time, or you can set start and end dates if you want to promote something for a very specific period of time. Other options include when it appears for your visitor after they arrive on your site, if it appears on very specific pages, and whether it's only shown on mobile, desktop, or both. And the final step here is to check your theme settings. You can choose global settings like your colors, fonts, and appearance of buttons. Once you're happy, click the Enable button and your form will be live, ready to collect subscribers. As your email list grows, it's important that you can send messages to specific groups of people. This helps to ensure your emails are always relevant instead of sending out the same message to everyone, which is a very quick way to annoy people and get them to unsubscribe. You can achieve this by segmenting your audience, which simply means splitting your audience into smaller lists based on whatever criteria you choose. Depending on what you sell, this might be their gender, where they live, how old they are, or what they've purchased in the past. You can segment your audience into different lists based on the form they use to sign up. So if people sign up on different product pages, you can send them relevant information and avoid sending them products that they're less likely to care about. You can also segment based on their engagement with your emails. Do they only engage around the holidays? Do they ignore most of your emails? Do they open all of your emails and could they be considered VIPs? Take it even further and segment them by lifestyle. How? If they're browsing products related to health and fitness, they may also be interested in receiving emails around nutrition or other healthy living factors. A health and wellness segment could include these people. Meanwhile, if they view children's items or stationery, a parenting segment might be viable. And they might be interested in receiving offers at the start of the school year. Now, I know what you're thinking. This looks awesome, Bernard, but it sounds really complicated and time-consuming. Good news, it's actually not. Omnisend makes audience segmentation a breeze. You already saw that you can add tags to your forms, which automatically creates those segments. There are also pre-built segments you can work with. Click Audiences at the top of the screen and then Segments. Here you can see your existing segments and create a new one with a long list of options. Because this account is new, we don't have the context to segment, so let's take a look at the pre-built segments instead. These segments are based on engagement. Are these people engaged or not? Are they likely to buy or likely to unsubscribe from your list? Do they visit your store frequently and do they click on your promotional messages? Using these segments, you can re-engage people or send more emails to increase the lifetime value of your best customers. Plus, sending emails to your most engaged recipients will help to improve your deliverability rate and other important key metrics. In the audience area of your account, you'll also see a menu item called Customer Breakdown. Here, you'll see various statistics about your audience and store orders. Underneath these lifecycle maps, you'll see 8 audience groups: recent customers, loyalists, champions, need nurturing, high potential, at risk, can't lose, and about to lose. Omnisend automatically adds members of your audience to these groups based on their behavior. So, for example, if a customer hasn't bought from you in a long time, they'll go into your about to lose section. If they bought from you previously but haven't been active for a while, they'll go into your need nurturing. Champions are people who bought several high value items, including a recent purchase. You'll see how many customers are in these groups, and you have the option to view them and send them a message. This is a great example of why segments are so important. Regular shoppers shouldn't get the same email as someone at risk of unsubscribing from your list. If all of your subscribers are in a single master list, you have no choice but to email all of them the same message. But with different lists, you can tailor what you say to them. This makes every email far more relevant to each recipient, which increases its effectiveness. As you can see, Omnisend makes it very easy to segment your audience as you'd like, as well as automatically grouping people into lifecycle stages so you can tailor your emails accordingly and easily. So far, we've covered how to set up your account, building forms and landing pages to grow your audience, and segmenting that audience. Now, let's turn our attention to designing your emails. Select email, and you'll be able to set details like the subject line, sender name, and email address, and an internal campaign name if you want. The subject line is the difference between an email that gets opened and one that sits unread and dead in the inbox, so I recommend spending a little bit of time creating a good one. Omnisend has a free subject line tester, which gives you a score and recommendations for how to improve your subject line. This tool also shows you how the subject line will appear on desktop and mobile, so you can see if it will get cut off for being too long. Once that's done, click Next at the bottom of the page, and it's time to select the template. If you set up your branding in the earlier step, you'll already see your logo and colors in the templates. If not, you'll have to use your imagination when looking at these templates. Omnisend has dozens of templates you can choose from, and you can filter by your goal to easily find what you need. Goals include welcome and engage, to promote products, announce a sale, offer a discount, and holiday celebrations, including Christmas and Black Friday. Now, select the one you want and let's get designing. If you think the template is already perfect, then all you need to do is change the text content. But if you want to do more, you absolutely can. On the left side of the page, you'll see the library, and this is where you can change how your email looks. While we're here, I would like to quickly mention saved items and saved layouts. With Omnisend, you can save your favorite elements and layouts to quickly retrieve them in the future emails, saving you a lot of time. The options on the library let you change pretty much everything. The number of columns, the style of the body text, the placement of your logo and pre-header, add new images and videos, an image gallery, social media links, and so much more. One of my favorite features is the product recommender. This block automatically adds up to 8 of your products from your store, and these products are live, updating every single hour. The feature checks the latest information on your site moments before the email is sent, so you can be sure your recipients are getting the very latest information. Now, if you're wondering what gets recommended, you actually get to choose. In the settings panel on the right-hand side of the screen, select the drop-down box under type and choose either bestsellers or newest products. You can also change how the products appear in the email and how many are included. And of course, you have complete control over what details are included: image, title, description, price, and even the old price. Now, to manually add products instead, insert the product listing block. While you're designing the email, remember that the little details can have a big impact. It's easy to upload whatever images you have available, but it's actually more effective to ensure the pictures are all high quality. They should show the products clearly, have good lighting, and be of a high resolution instead of dull, pixelated, and unclear. And look at your header and footer. They should be clear, simple, and add to the overall look of your email without being distracting or in the way. They can also add to the navigation of the email with quick links and information. The header should have a prominent logo, and you can experiment with a menu bar or a link to a landing page. Don't overdo it though. The header shouldn't be cluttered or detract from the main body of the email. You want your focus to be on your products, remember? The footer can be different. This is where you can have links to your terms and conditions, social media pages, returns policies, FAQs, and of course, very important, an unsubscribe button. The header and footer should also be consistent between emails, so over time they become familiar to your readers and a signature feature of your brand. You want your customers to remember your design. All of these small details give your emails a professional, polished look that will help your brand to stand out. That's especially true when compared with the monotonous emails that a lot of other brands send out. So it's a simple, quick way to get ahead. Once you finish designing, send yourself a test email at the top of the screen, and then you can click on the button to finish editing. You're now able to choose your recipients and can send your email to everyone or very specific segments. In addition to sending emails manually, you can also set up automated workflows. With these active, your audience will receive specific messages when they take certain actions. They'll receive a welcome series when they sign up, or an abandoned cart email if they add items to their cart but leave without buying them. In 2022, automated emails made up nearly 32% of all email orders, but only 2% of all emails sent, so they're definitely worth using. To get started, select automation from the top of the page in your Omnisend account and then explore all workflows. Now, you'll see the pre-built workflow templates that you can use if you don't want to start from scratch. There are workflows to welcome new subscribers, overcome an abandoned cart, confirm orders or shipping or cancellations, commemorate a birthday, announce items are back in stock, cross-sell products, build loyalty, and so much more. Simply select the one you want to build first. Then you can add your emails and SMS and set your specifications for when the workflow is triggered. Finally, once you've sent your emails, you can monitor their performance. Just click the Reports tab in your Omnisend account and you can review the performance of your emails for each campaign, the statistics for your automated workflows, and how well your forms are converting visitors into subscribers. You'll see not only the performance numbers, but additional information including the location of your audience, which languages they speak, and the devices used. All of this information can be used to help you create future campaigns or refine your existing ones to improve performance. You'll also see a deliverability tab in the reports page. This is a very important area because if your emails aren't being delivered to the inbox, then it doesn't really matter how good they are. No one will see them and no one will open them. In the deliverability area, you'll see your email list hygiene, which tells you what your percentage of high or medium risk contacts are. Of course, you want it to be low, so if it isn't, follow the list cleaning options to improve it. This process will remove fake or unknown email addresses. As a bonus, you won't just have a higher quality list, but you'll also cut costs for inactive contacts and enjoy a higher engagement rate. You'll also see send a warm-up on the deliverability page. To avoid your high quality, legitimate emails going to the spam folder, it's important to go through the send a warm-up process. Omnisend handles it for you, gradually increasing the number of emails you send over a period of days or weeks. This builds a very good sender reputation, so you're more likely to land in the inbox where your subscribers can see you. And that's it for this tutorial. I really hope you saw just how simple it is if you follow an email marketing step-by-step guide. We've looked at starting an account, building your forms, emails, workflows, and segmenting your audience. As a next step, if you're still looking for a platform to use, then it's a great time to get started with Omnisend. Just click the link in the description below and use the code found on YouTube to get 10% off your first 3 months. If you want more tips on building a successful marketing strategy, don't miss this video about incorporating SMS. In that video, I show you why SMS is so effective and how you can start using it. And yes, Omnisend supports SMS too, and you can even send messages in the same automation workflows as emails.